know, Beverly Johnson does not require introduction, but today's totally dynamic first presentation of two wonderful productions she's sharing with us. One is her amazing new hair care, body care line, Beverly Johnson, available online and at Target. And the other is her wonderful new show coming up on this Saturday. I love connecting great people, and what I really love about Brandis Henderson, who's on my right, who's the CEO of Harlem's Fashion Row, for those of you who aren't familiar with her, she actually has taken the question mark of why aren't there more blacks, why aren't there more Spanish, why aren't there more people of color in the business of fashion, and provide a solution. So she does these business roundtables. Not only does she have the fashion show, but she sits the designers down with buyers and really does make a difference. And so there's an emerging icon on my right and a well-known one on my left. So we're going to do a conversation between the two of them first. We have an open conversation with the table. Again, we're so pleased that you're here to share this day with us, and I'm going to turn it over to them now. When I found out about the Beverly Johnson show and the new project that she had coming up, I really was excited about getting involved. She is such an icon and really has done such an amazing job at just paving the way for all of us who work in fashion. And so I thought it was just appropriate for us to do something that paid homage to her.
I knew that the modeling career was going to be short. So I came in thinking, what, I love the business, I love being introduced to the arts, so I knew that I was home. But I was trying to figure out a way to expand that career. And I said, Procter & Gamble, okay, Beverly Johnson, what concept?
Here's a quote from your blog. He said, I had always been a girl on the box. Now I own the box and look. Now, I know that you had an eyewear line that was in Sears, and that was successful for 10 years. And everyone knows about the iconic Beverly Johnson ponytail and wig line that's been successful for the last 14 years.
But one of the reasons why I wanted to go into the business is because I wanted to be able to go into a black beauty supply store and buy my product. And I wanted that money to stay in the community, and I thought because we're such a big participant in that $1 billion industry,
yes, we are,
that we needed to start participating in every way. So every morning when I wake up with purpose. Not only the purpose to make a dollar, but the purpose to make a difference. And to develop a business model that others can use to go into the beauty business, the fashion business, where we know we love it. Right. We have a love affair with our hair, that's never going to change.
Right.
So we need to participate in it in every way.
Now speaking of Ananza, who's your daughter? And your granddaughter, Ava. How are they? Because Ava is too cute.
My daughter and I were just here. She was just here yesterday. We did the Wendy Williams show. She started off as a regular model. Of course, I didn't want her to model. And she got out of high school 2 years early, and she went to New York to become a model. And she got down to a size 2. And then all the photographers in the magazine started, you know, buying for her. And I got the call. She says, Mom, I want to come home. I said, why? Because I was getting used to not doing that. Why? She says, well, I just fainted in the elevator and I'm hungry. She said, and I'm never going to let anybody tell me how I should look ever again. I said, wow, it took me at 40 years old to get to that point in life, and you're doing it at 18. So she went back to school and got her BA and her MBA. And then I got the phone call, Mom, guess what? You're pregnant. No. I want to be a plus size model. I said, oh, Ananza, that's fake, but why do you want to be a plus size model? She said, I want to be the role model for women who have curves to embrace the body they have. I said, you go, girl.
Yeah, I know that.
And that's my daughter. She's my hero.
I can only imagine me and Mama. I mean, we get along pretty good, but we have some interesting moments.
Yes.
What gave you the courage to actually show those private moments on national TV?
Well, I'm always trying to get my daughter to, move, spend more time with me. And then when I realized that, she was going to have a baby, I said, oh my God, I could have them all with me. I could get them back. And then my daughter, who was a big reality television fan, said, yeah, that sounds great, Mom, let's do a reality show. Because if I had told my daughter, why don't we talk to a life coach and a therapist about our relationship? She was, Mom, I could really think it's great that you have a therapist and all, and you really do need one, but I don't, So, it just all made sense.
Back in the 70s and 80s, we had, more Asian models, more black models on the runway. They would send 3 and 4 down at a time, and they twist and turn, and suddenly we've gone backwards. And the same thing with television. You had Good Times, you had The Cosby Show. You can't find a black show other than on BET right now. And it's sketchy. But, why? And obviously in your career, you had The Peaks, and then there was a quiet time. And it's taken you to now to be able to get a product line out there in full mass form. What's your opinion of why this has all sort of gone backwards? And are we going forward today, or are we just stuck?
Well, I think that by just having this conversation, we started to, go forward. I think that, if you're not going forward, you're going backwards. So I think the point is to stay in movement, stay in action.
I want you to tell us something about yourself that we don't know, that we'd be surprised to know, and hopefully something that no one in this room knows.
Watch the school house. I'm telling you, I don't know what's going to go on there because we were ourselves, and and that's the good news and that's the bad news. So we'll find out.
Let's
all, as the boy says, keep it moving.
Thank you so much.